Lord Krishna had a brahmana friend named Sudama, who was very knowledgeable in Vedic literature and was greatly detached from all sense of enjoyment. Furthermore, his mind was peaceful and his senses were subdued. He provided for himself and his household with whatever food and alms came his way. His wife too greatly suffered along with him and was starving due to lack of proper food.
My Lord, isn't it true that the great Lord Krishna is your close friend? He is said to be very compassionate to all brahmanas and very willing to grant them his shelter. Please approach him. He will readily give us alms.
All right, I will do as you wish. If there is anything in the house I can take as a gift for him, please give it to me.
Sudama's wife begged for 4 handfuls of flat rice from neighboring brahmanas, tied up the rice in a torn piece of cloth and gave it to her husband as a present for Lord Krishna. Taking the flat rice, the saintly brahmana set off for Dwaraka. Lord Krishna spotted him coming from a great distance away. He immediately stood up, went forward to meet him and embraced him with great joy. Lord Krishna made him sit on the bed. Then the Lord personally offered him flowers as a token of respect, washed his feet and sprinkled water on his head. He anointed him with fragrant sandalwood pastes and worshipped him with aromatic incense and arrays of lamps. After finally offering him betel nut and fruits, he welcomed him with pleasing words.
My dear brahmana, do you remember how we lived together in our spiritual master's school? You know the ways of dharma very well. After you offered Guru Dakshina to our guru and returned home from his school, did you marry a suitable girl?
I am now happily married with children, my lord.
Even though you are managing your family, it is indeed remarkable how your mind is not affected by material desires till this moment.
Krishna, I am contented and happy.
Sudama, what gift have you brought me from home?
Sudama felt too embarrassed to offer his gift of flat rice to Krishna. He simply bowed his head in shame.
In the past, Sudama never worshipped me out of a desire for material gain. But now, he has come to me to satisfy his wife. I will give him riches that even the immortal demigods cannot obtain.
From Sudama's garments, Krishna snatched the cloth that held the grains of flat rice.
What is this that you have brought for me, friend?
Saying this, Krishna ate 1 handful of rice and was about to eat a second when the devoted goddess Rukmini took hold of his hand.
This is more than enough, O Lord of the universe, to secure him with an abundance of all kinds of wealth in this world and the next.
The next day, Sudama set off for home after being honored by Lord Krishna. Although he had received no riches from Lord Krishna, Sudama was too shy to beg for it on his own. He simply returned home, feeling perfectly satisfied at having met his good friend. Sudama finally reached the place where his home used to be. But instead of his humble shack, he saw a towering celestial palace with a splendid courtyard and garden filled with flocks of cooing birds and beautified by ponds filled with lotuses.
What is all this? Whose house is this? How did this happen?
The brahmana's wife quickly came out of the palace in a jubilant flurry and solemnly bowed to him. Sudama was amazed to see his wife.
It seems my good friend Lord Krishna noticed that I secretly intended to beg from him. Thus, even though he said nothing about it when I stood before him, he actually bestowed upon me the most abundant riches. Life after life, may I serve him with love, friendship and loyalty.
Anyone who hears this account of the Supreme Lord's kindness to his loyal followers will learn to love the Lord and thus become free from the bondage of material pleasure.